in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic, which forced millions to stay at home, we were tasked with helping Epic Games build their store brand, accelerate growth, and challenge the market leader Steam on a global scale. So, we went bold and launched The Vault, an unprecedented 4-week campaign that consisted of a series of weekly free game giveaways that included some of the industry's biggest game franchises, and let people keep them forever. Wow! That's amazing. To get the word out to our global audience, we created a 100% digital meaningful media experience and tailored it to the 20 countries and cultures we were speaking to. We went to the places we knew our audience would be, hitting them with eye-catching call-to-action videos on social platforms, connected TV, and YouTube. On Imgur, we increased positive brand perception by removing ads for the day, making our offer unmissable. On Spotify, we drove demand thanks to our takeovers on the homepage, New Music Fridays, and Discover Weekly sections. We even reached out to our biggest haters on the Fuck Epic subreddit with a bespoke creative ad, something that had never been done before, resulting in positive comments from a hostile audience. Partnering with Twitch, we worked with micro-influencers who streamed our games live in exchange for a bounty when they hit certain stream viewership metrics. The campaign was so successful. On day one, we broke the Epic Games Store and had to pause our advertising.
Epic Games has been crashed.
We made it to the top 4 trending on Reddit. Overnight, we saw 4 times the number of new account signups, 13 million average peak concurrent user count, 61 million monthly active users total, 777 million video completes, doubling the awareness in the US. In just 4 weeks, this historic growth rate put Epic within striking distance of Steam, which had a 15-year head start. With that kind of fan love, the Epic Games Store had truly lived up to its name.